Hello everyone, in this video tutorial I'm going to talk about basic statistics using MATLAB. Now statistics is a mathematical science which involves collection, analysis and interpolation of data. MATLAB provides us with an easy way in which you can calculate all the parameters that are essential to do statistical analysis, for example mean, median, mode, etc. So let's get on with it. I'll initialize a matrix M which will act as our data set for which we'll calculate all the parameters. Okay, so that is M. Let's start with mean. If we have to calculate mean for all the columns that are present in matrix M, we will have to pass our matrix M to this mean function like this, and it will calculate mean for all the columns. Similarly, if you have to calculate mean for all the rows, you'll just change the format to this and you'll get mean for all the rows. Similarly, to calculate median, we'll do the same thing. So median . This will calculate column-wise median, whereas if we change it to 2, it will calculate row-wise median. Similarly, mode can be calculated. This is column-wise mode calculation, and this is the row-wise calculation. Another important parameter that is used for statistical analysis is the standard deviation and variance. Standard deviation can be calculated using the inbuilt standard deviation function STD, and we'll save all the values to S. So while calculating standard deviation, we'll have to pass the dimensions as well as we'll have to pass the variable W. Now, W is something that will help in normalization of the calculated standard deviation values. W can either be 0, 1, or it can be a vector which is equal to the dimensions of the matrix M that is being passed. If the value of W is 0, the normalization takes place according to the number of values that are present in the data set minus 1. And if the value of W is 1, the normalization takes place according to the number of values that is present in the data set. So I'm going to show you both ways and you can observe both the changes. So I'm calculating standard deviation for all the columns. So I'll put dimension as 1, and this is the standard deviation for W is equal to 0. If we change W to 1, you can observe all the changes. Similarly, standard deviation for rows will be this. You can also calculate variance in the similar fashion. We have to pass W in this case as well. I'll calculate variance for rows. You can also calculate variance for columns like this. Apart from all these parameters that are discussed above, another important thing that is required in statistical analysis is the value of minimum or maximum that is present in the matrix M. So in order to do that, we will have to pass the matrix M to the function min that will calculate the minimum. This again will calculate the minimum for every row that is being present in matrix M. So these are the minimum values. Similarly, if you want to calculate minimum for rows, we'll have to change the format to this. This is the row-wise minimum. To calculate maximum value, we'll have to pass the matrix to max function. This will calculate column-wise maximum, whereas if we change it to this, it will calculate row-wise maximum. So that's it for today. And if you need further help, you may log in to www.matlabhelper.com. Thank you. Enjoy.